Should you upgrade to macOS Ventura? There are a few steps you need to take before upgrading any OS, and macOS Ventura is no different. So here's what to do before upgrading to macOS Ventura. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode, and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips and app reviews. Today, I'm sharing the 5 things you should do before upgrading to macOS Ventura. Plus, I'll throw a few bonus tips in at the end. Let's go. Step 1, check compatibility. You're gonna wanna make sure your device is even capable of running macOS Ventura. If you head to support.apple.com, and I actually have a link below, you can find a whole list of computers that are compatible with macOS Ventura. I've included this link in the description, but generally you're going to have a device from 2017 or newer. But that does differ depending on the computer you have, so it's key to check this list. So if you're still wondering, well, which device do I have? Just click the Apple logo in the top left and select About This Mac. In this pop-up, you will see the device that you have. Step 2, make sure you have enough free space. It sounds simple enough, but this is crucial prior to any OS upgrade. So it's gonna take around 12 gigs of space to update from Monterey to Ventura. But if you're still running, say, Sierra or Big Sur, it could take even more space. So generally, I'd say you want to double the installer space required. So ensure you've got at least 24 gigs of free space. To check how much space you have on your drive, click that Apple logo again in the top left, and then once again, select About This Mac. From here, select Storage, and you'll get a snapshot of the storage space left on your device. Step 3, check app compatibility. This is huge. This is probably the biggest thing I tell people before upgrading macOS. Do not upgrade your macOS before you've checked your third-party app compatibility. Because here's the thing. Before I upgraded to Big Sur in, 2020, I did not check any app compatibility. And guess what? A lot of my apps broke. So what do I mean by that? Well, a lot of my third-party editing themes and plugins were not compatible with that version of macOS. So they either broke completely, did not work, or I had to wait because they required a fix before they could work with my editing software on Big Sur. I am telling you, learn from my mistake. To this day, even after upgrading to Monterey all these years later, some of my plugins are still not compatible. This is not a joke. So I really want you to think about what apps you use on a daily basis and make sure they are compatible. Have I made myself clear? So here's an example. I use Camtasia to screen record all my videos. If I go to their site, I can click on Full System Requirements to see a complete compatibility list. So this is really important for video editors, audio engineers, students. So if you're a student, you're gonna wanna check with your school's tech department first to ensure you're even gonna be able to run your programs efficiently and effectively. And beware, because certain apps like Camtasia or certain plugins where they don't actually name the macOS, just the version number, the app could still have issues. So just double check everything before upgrading. But some third-party apps like Adobe Creative Cloud will tell you specifically which version of macOS it's compatible with. And keep this in mind, it could be weeks or months before Ventura is available. So for me, I've waited about 2 months to upgrade to Ventura because of these compatibility concerns. Am I making myself clear? Whew. And with that, step 4, back up your Mac prior to updating. Along with step 3, this is the next most crucial step because you never know if something's gonna go wrong when you're upgrading a macOS. So it is crucial to have an up-to-date backup prior to upgrading. So there are a couple of ways to back up your device. My preferred method is to use Time Machine. This is really easy to do. You just need an external hard drive, and when you plug in your hard drive to your Mac should instantly recognize the device and ask if you want to use it as a backup disk. Now, if this doesn't automatically pop up for you, you can just head to System Preferences and select Time Machine, or select that Time Machine from your menu bar at the top. And then from here, click on Select Backup and follow the prompts. So like I said, I like to keep Time Machine right up in my top bar here for easy access, but it is preference for you. Now, backing up can take some time depending on how much storage you have used on your device, which brings me to step number 5. Ensure you have enough time to upgrade to macOS Ventura. Do not rush this process. So first of all, like we just went over, backing up your Mac could take time. Luckily, you should be able to do some work while backing up. It can slow things down a bit for you though. Second of all, downloading macOS Ventura could take anywhere, 40 minutes to an hour. Again, you can work during this step, but things might be slower for you. Most importantly, once you hit install, you're gonna want the installation to complete without putting your Mac to sleep or closing the lid on the laptop. So I recommend starting this entire process maybe at the end of your workday so you can just let your Mac sit and take its time installing the upgrade. Now with all this said, I have 2 bonus tips for you. First, no matter what OS you're upgrading, whether iOS or iPadOS or macOS, I always recommend waiting until there is another version release. Here's what I mean. If we go back to our About This Mac section, you're gonna wanna take note of the version number. So for example, I'm running macOS Monterey 12.6, meaning the first iteration of Monterey was version 12. So there have already been 6 other patches to Monterey, or little updates, if you will. For macOS, Apple updates the patch version for every release. So this is really important to understand because these patches contain important supplemental updates. So remember how I said I waited a couple months to upgrade to Ventura because of compatibility reasons? That's part of the reason. The other part is I wanted to make sure there's a minor update to Ventura first. We can easily tell if there have been patches to Ventura by once again clicking our Apple logo in the top left, System Preferences, and Software Update. Here it says Ventura 3.1. So I know right off the bat there's been a minor update to macOS 13. Because oftentimes what happens with brand new releases is there can be bugs in the operating system. So if you wait until, say, 13.1 instead of upgrading right away when it was released, you could avoid some annoying bugs. And this brings us to bonus tip number 2. Always keep macOS Ventura up to date. So remember, when you decide to update, keep upgrading as these patches become available. Because as Apple releases patches to their operating system, bugs are going to be worked out of the system. And you'll also be up to date with any important security updates. So these are my steps on what to do before upgrading to macOS Ventura. Will you be upgrading? Have you already installed Ventura? Let me know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here and here for even more Mac videos. Thanks for watching. See you next time.